AssalamuAlaikum. Hello, kids. How are you today? Are you ready for today's episode? Insha'Allah, I am going to tell you the story of Prophet Dawud alayhi salam today. Are you ready, children? Now listen carefully. Bismillah. The story of Prophet Dawud alayhi salam. Do you know how Talut took his small team of men to fight against the huge army of Philistines? The Philistine army was led by a giant man named Galut. He challenged Talut's army for a single combat, as was the custom of battle in those days. Giant Galut also wanted to show off his strength. Talut's men were terrorized, and no one had enough courage to volunteer. No one was willing to fight giant Goliath, even when the king offered the hand of his pretty daughter in marriage to the man who fought him. Then, to everyone's surprise, a young boy stepped forward. A roar of laughter echoed from the enemy's side. Even Talut's men shook their heads in disapproval. The young man was none other than Prophet Dawud alayhi salam. His elderly father had chosen three of his sons to join Talut's army. He had instructed the youngest, Dawud alayhi salam, not to take part in the fighting, but to help the army in other ways. He was also supposed to report to his father daily on what was happening at the war front. Although the king was very impressed by the youth's courage, he said, "I admire your courage, but you are no match for that mighty warrior. Let the strong men come forward." Dawud alayhi salam, however, had already decided and was willing to meet the challenge. Proudly, he told the king that only the day before he had killed a lion, which had threatened his father's sheep. And he told him about another occasion where he killed a huge bear as well. "Please don't judge me by my appearance," requested the young boy. "I fear no man or wild beast." The king, surprised by the young boy's brave stance, agreed. "My brave soldier, if you are willing, then may Allah guard you and grant you strength." The king dressed the young prophet in battle armor and handed him a sword. But Dawud alayhi salam was not used to wearing battle dress. He felt uncomfortable in it, and it obstructed his movements. He removed the armor, then collected a few pebbles and filled his leather pouch with them. He slung it over his shoulder next to his sling. With his wooden staff in hand, he began to walk towards the enemy. Talut was worried. He asked him, "How on earth, with a sling and a couple of stones, are you going to defend yourself against the giant?" Then Dawud alayhi salam replied, "Allah, who protected me from the claws of the bear and the fangs of the lion, will certainly protect me from this brute." When Galut saw the lean young man who looked like a boy, he laughed loudly and roared, "Are you out to play with one of your playmates? Or are you tired of your life? I will simply cut off your head with one swipe of my sword." Then the prophet shouted back, "You may have armor, shield, and sword, but I face you in the name of Allah, the Lord of our people, whose laws you have mocked. Today, you will see that it is not the sword that kills, but the will and power of Allah." So saying, he took his sling and placed in it a pebble from his pouch. He swung the sling, aiming it at Galut. The pebble shot from the whirling sling with the speed of an arrow and hit Galut's head with great force. Blood gushed out, and Galut thumped to the ground, lifeless, before he even had a chance to draw his sword. when the rest of his men saw their mighty hero slain, they took to their heels. Dawud alayhi salam became a hero overnight. People cheered and welcomed him. Talut kept his word and married his daughter Mikael to the young warrior. He also took him under his wing as one of his chief advisors. The Prophet became the most famous man among his people. However, he was not enveiled by this. He was not a prisoner of fame or leadership, but a prisoner of Allah's love. Therefore, after killing Galut, he went out into the desert in the company of nature, glorifying Almighty Allah and contemplating His favors. The plants, the birds, the beasts, and even the mountains responded to his voice, glorifying Allah. It was not the Prophet's sweet voice that made the birds and beasts join him. Allah had endowed him with the knowledge of understanding the languages of birds and animals as well. The people praised and loved Dawud alayhi salam. However, the hearts of men are fickle and memories short. Even great men can feel insecure and become petty-minded. Talut had become envious of the Prophet. When he saw how the people love him, he started getting insecure. And finally, he decided to kill the Prophet. Such is jealousy that not even his daughter's well-being mattered to him. Mikael learned of her father's plans. She hurried to her husband and warned him about the plans. The Prophet gathered some food and things, mounted his camel, and fled. He found a cave in which he remained hidden for many days. After a while, his brothers and some citizens too joined forces with him. The situation of Talut had grown very weak by now. He started ruling with a heavy hand. He ill-treated his subjects and tortured them. He terrorized his soldiers as well. This worsened his position, and his subjects began to slowly turn against him. When Talut heard the news that some of his citizens had joined forces with the Prophet, he was really angry. He then decided to go to war against the Prophet. They traveled through the valleys for many days to find the Prophet and his army. They had traveled a great distance by now, and all of the men were overcome by fatigue. They decided to rest for a while in the valley, where all of them soon fell asleep. Talut, who was very tired as well, slept in a cave too. It was then that the Prophet quietly crept up to him, removed his spear, and cut off a piece of garment with the sword. The Prophet then climbed the nearby mountain and shouted, "O King, you come out seeking me, but I do not hate you, and I do not want to kill you. If I did, I would have killed you when you were asleep. Here is a piece of garment. I could have killed you instead of cutting this piece of cloth, but I did not. My mission is that of love, not malice." Talut realized his mistake and begged for forgiveness. He then returned with his army back to his kingdom. Did you like the video, kids? Don't forget to click that subscribe button and notification bell to keep updated on our latest videos. Inshallah, in the next episode, I will tell you another story of Prophet Dawud alayhi salam. That's all for today. Goodbye!